noise of that van. Not quite sure why it's noisy. It wasn't noisy before. Maybe the cold. Maybe turn it down a bit. Anyway, these are my GoPro mounts that I made, and I want to spray them up. So first thing I have to do is get that off. Just to break it off, get that off. Keep that nut and bolt handy. Try not to lose that. I just want to spray it up. Put that light on, get some more light in here. And I've got a wee spray booth. It's just a sheet, you know. This is the sheet up against the wall. And look, it's coming off of the can. That's it. Just that. That radio down. There's a hook. And I've got some of this stuff, fantastic. It's been really good. Plastic up. Yep, it's on. Have a bit of drink of coffee. Now the other one, I kind of want to adjust this one because it's at the right height. It sits like that on the bolt for the exhaust. But there is a bit of vibration. I noticed when it was lower, there was no vibration, so I'm going to try and brace it. I'll leave that for now. Well, this one's dry, I don't need this in the way. I could actually put a washer and bolt back on there. I don't actually know why I've got that fan on, it doesn't need to be on. Just got to clean this bracket up. Get this out of the way. Get a wee sheet. Get a sheet just to put it on. I've got some acetone. Acetone is nail varnish remover, but it does a good job of cleaning. I've got to clean this up. I don't think it's too bad. I just need to just get all the junk off, all the dirt off it. Just give that a clean. Get all the. Just get it nice and clean, ready for painting. And I'll just spray it up. My nails a little bit, they're getting a bit long. That feels nice and clean now. There's some junk in there I need to get out. What's that there? This feels like a bit of metal. Let's see if I can file it off a little bit. Just a little bit of stuff. I'll try not to touch it now. Just touch it with a cloth and hang it on that little hook. Open these jaws a little bit. so I can put the cameras on the jaws, the camera on the jaws, and I can show you me spraying it up. It's quite a good idea. It's just a little bit of, it's a windowing bottle with the nail varnish remover in it. Far easier. Let's get this off here. That's it, that's out of there. I haven't got another SD card for the camera. That's having to go there. Let's get this. I usually use the hairdryer to I've got an exhaust fan at the moment, but I haven't got much ventilation, so I shall open the door. What I normally do is I get the hairdryer on the can of paint. Just open this door up. I'm going to wear a wee mask as well because I closed an area, so I think a mask would be wise. I take my spectacles off because I can't see the steam up, that's what I do. And what I do is I heat the metal up and I heat the can up. Just have to stick it there. It gives it more of a gloss finish. It kind of goes matte because it's cold. It should really close that door because it's very cold tonight. So I'll just close the door. Just put the mask on. There's not going to be a vast amount of paint anyway. See that? Here with the mask on, it gets fumy in here. I can't actually see what I'm doing today, so I haven't got my spectacles on. I see I've missed quite a big bit there. Do that. I'll do that for the first coat for now. Just put my glasses and inspect that. It's not too bad with the door open. And the extractor fan, it would have been a lot worse without the door open. Let's have a look, any drips? Let's have a look. Oh. So let me put it up to the light. Doesn't look too bad. Have I missed anywhere? I missed on an edge along there. Coat. I'll give it 2 or 3 coats. Okay. I'll just let the air clear a little bit and then I'll have a look at this. What do you call it? I'm going to have a look at this other bracket. Put the camera up there. Let's put the camera back in the Gorilla plus selfie homemade pod. There we go. Get this out of the way. That's it. Hang that there. That should be okay. Those lights actually turned out okay. It's going on nice. That is lovely stuff to work with, that plastic coat. Right. This one. See if I want other bits of metal. Probably in the corner here. I just need something to brace it. All this metal here. There's something that kind of wrecked this a little bit, but I don't think it's the right diameter. Yeah, it is. I could get a brace off there somehow. Not too late to start hacking things. It's only 5:45. That's a contender. So is that. They're the same kind of diameter. That's the same diameter. All the same stuff. I must have bought a bar of it at some point. What is this here? This is quite good. Man, this might just do the trick. Might do the job nicely. That I just want to brace it and make it like a triangle kind of brace. Yeah, I kind of know what I'm going to do there. Alright, let's do it. That'll do that a little bit. I don't know if it's harder than this though. This must look maybe a bit softer to work with. I'll keep this little bit out. It's quite dirty, but don't matter if it's dirty, I'll clean up. I'll use these two bits of contenders. Scrap them out of the way. This is from when I made a little stubby exhaust, cut up off exhaust. It was all dented and damaged, so I cut the damage out. I'm gonna close that door now. I think the fumes have just about gone. So that's the door shut. And what we've got to determine is I want to bend this pop light in there because the hole shouldn't be far away. And then bend it to a back on itself. I'm going to need heat for that. I want to bend it at quite an acute angle. It's to go in there and has to come back, and we can worry about the length of it later. I'm just trying to work out the bend in it. Mark where I'm going to start bending it. Even that's not hypercritical. As long as it's past that bolt. And we want it to look neat, don't we? Whereas I've moved everything, you see, I can't find anything. Where's my marker pen? I had a marker pen for this job. There it is. I kind of want to blow it, and I've got this thing here, a blowtorch. I'm going to have to move that bit of, put this paint job somewhere else. Pop the paint job there, move this, anything that's going to go on fire has to be moved. Including that box down there. Because the only decent way to bend anything is to use heat. It's the only way you'll do it. And this is kind of some pieces that you're sawing out. And move this bin outside just to give myself. Give the flames some space to go somewhere without setting fire to anything. So I'll pop the bin outside for now. And I'll move these with them. It goes like that. Copy. So I want it to bend on that line. And it's got to bend right back. Up against that. And get it straight-ish. So I could probably just bend it in the vice, but I reckon it'll snap. Now which way am I going? So I want the hole there. Get that out of the way. I want the hole there, because there's a hole kind of naturally there. And I want it to come back that way. So I'm going to heat this up. I don't know if it'll bend in the vice, whether it'll kind of I'll tighten that up. How do you do this? Do it like that? To get it 90 degrees. No, the vise isn't square. And the vise isn't square, it's not a good. I can't get a right angle with that thing, can I? I can't use that there. That's right angles there. Turn up with that. And then we can bend it just back. Plastic cup out of the way. I don't know if that'll put stress on it. Thank you. a lot of impurities on there. want it to bend here. Nice 90 degree angle. I might have to cut that. I wonder if it's possible to cut it now. Put a little cut in it. Not too far through, and then try and bend it that way. I want it flat though. A little bit. Top. Gonna hammer that down. Oh, that's still warm. Hammer that flat. Stuff, man. Okay. See how that is. It's almost what I needed. I'll take that though. I will take that. Get this stuff out of the way. As you can see, that'll go in there. It's just for bracing. I could even just. Now, what do I want to do? That goes on like that, and I could pinch it flat while it's still relatively warm. Okay, let's undo this. What size is that then? I think that's an 8 mil. Yeah, it's an 8 mil. Maniac put that on there. Oh man. So if I just put that in there. Doesn't have to be that nut there. Could be this one. Even do it the other way. Like so. It goes like that, doesn't it? That'll let it. Take a bit off there, grind a bit off there. Close that door because it's really cold.
Oh.
see if that goes on now. How did that go? That went inside, didn't it? It's not too far away. Get a thinner bolt, maybe. The one I was using. That's tight. Obviously I'll take a bit more off that, I'll work that down a bit further. That's the kind of general idea. And what I want to do is squash it flat. If I can, I want to squash it about there. Okay. Just to brace it. There's a weak spot there because that's where the hole is. Let's try that. Well, it's still a wee bit warm, you know. Lines up. Okay. So all I need to do is put an 8mm spanner on there. That hole just about lines up. Hack the end off that. Mark where I need to hack it. And I'm hoping that'll brace it. I don't need to come all the way down there. I just, off. Take this off. Okay. Hack this bit off. Thank you. Okay. Just gonna, that's gonna be on the inside there. It's not gonna really matter. But I would like to make it a bit safer for working on. Put this all together. So that's where the GoPro mounts. Okay. I think there needs to be a little bit more come off that, but it's okay. Pop that through there. Possibly need a longer bolt. See, just fiddle out with a shorter bolt. Just get it started. Once it's started, get it in there tight. I don't even get that in there and dart it. I'll have to get a spanner in there. I want to do that now really. An 8mm spanner just to get it good and tight. That's it now. Make sure I'm the right way around. It goes on like that, doesn't it? So this has to come like so. Yep. And I'm hoping that will brace it. Oh, space to get a spanner in there. Don't want it to move at all, because that's half the problem with mounts. If they move even slightly a little bit, they vibrate. Can you imagine the all these forces on a moving motorcycle? It'd be better doing this after getting it in the vise. It's interesting that there's a little cavity there, you know. It's like a happy accident that's appeared. Right, which way is that gonna go? Make it look smarter, go that way, because that's on the outside. Try and get that through there now. I really need a lock nut on that. I've got some lock nuts over here. Make a mess when you're working, don't we? Little lock nuts here, and before I paint this I'll test it. Fit on. Yep. That's possibly the same 8mm. Yeah, it is. And you get a little Allen key for that. Find an Allen key small enough. Should have. It's just a size too big. A smaller one. There it is, right at the bottom. So I'll just test this and then it is a wee bit squint. It don't matter. I'll test this and I'll get it painted up. Put a nice little washer on that. So it'll sit on the bike like that. I can hack a bit off that bolt. It's not exactly flush, but I can always just shave a bit off that. See if I can get in there to. Gonna sit at an angle when it's straight on the bike. It is. So it needs to be bent a little bit, tiny touch. Just to make it straight. And while it's bent I can sit straight, get in there. Yeah, that looks straight. And I can tighten that up while I'm here and get anything in there. Probably need a better 8mm than that. Be good and tight these. Just awkward. Everything's always awkward, isn't it? That's it. I'll try and test this out tomorrow. Get it sprayed up while I'm here. So, because is that a bit too far? I don't think it is. It's on the bike like that. No, I think that'll be just about right. So that's the bracing. Let's hope it does brace. It might. I might have been wiser to come down to take that bracket all the way down. If push comes to shove, I'm going to draw this out and make it slightly shorter, the bracket, and that'll make it really strong, because it might flex on there, but I don't think it will. I'm going to hack that bolt off. Just make it nice and neat. Oh, I forgot my coffee. A bit of a tidy up. So that's not been a bad wee job, that. It's been quite good. Thanks for that. Put this away. Hammer away. Put the bolts home, put the right angle home. Scrap bits of metal, bolt, butane torch. Did the job. And give it a kind of that fairly clean up. Should come out of there, no problem. So there we are, a modified bracket. That's not sitting flush completely, but it's okay. Interestingly, that's on the. It's not. I was going to say it was on the inside of the. But it's not. It doesn't really matter anyway. I can file that down. File it all flat. If I want to, if I'm not fussed, but I might just spray it up. Let's have a look at this other one. One wee blemish in it. I'm going to give it another quick coat and have a break. Get the bar sorted out. Touching the item. Okay, paint. Open the door. Gets very teamy with us. Just give it another quick coat. Let's touch. I can sit in here for long enough because I won't be putting it back on the bike for a little while. I'll leave that to dry. Just show you it quickly. Get it into the light. It's the best way to do this. And that plastic coat is nice paint. Look at that, lovely. If I shut this door, nothing will get in and spoil that. Okay, I'm gonna do that. Just shut this door. Make sure it doesn't touch anything. Nice job. Okay, so I'll let that dry, that should be okay. I'll maybe give it one more coat. Test this mount out, see if there's any vibration at all. If not, I'll paint it. Thank you for watching.